Randle with a screen for Russell. Back to Kobe. Good, and it's Russell picking up the assist. Bryant's got his first points of the game.
Oh, that is just weak defense there. I'm pretty sure that was not the plan to give him those kind of baskets at the hoop. Well, LeBron James, long considered the greatest player in the league, he's got some competition now, though. Kevin Durant, Anthony Davis, Steph Curry, James Harden, all playing well last year. But for my money, there's no better player in the league than King James.
Well, Clark, you look at LeBron's career averages right now, around 27, 7, and 7. Hard to argue at this time he's not the best player in the league.
Well, you know, he might not always win the MVP award, Kevin, but that doesn't really matter. I think he's the most feared player in the league, and he proved he can carry a team in last season's NBA Finals. Clearly, one of the all-time greats.
Both free throws good from Kyrie Irving.
Probably as close to a sure thing as you can have at the free throw line.
Randle kicks to Russell. Randle a screen on Irving. Inside. And then Hibbert with the dunk.
Whoa, that'll wake you up. My goodness.
Is he an athlete or what?
No doubt about it. It's almost as if he lives in the air. And dunks like that have become quite commonplace.
Now, here is Irving. He has 7. Launches a 3. And the basket good. Irving's got 10.
A good open look, and he splashes home the 3.
Lakers trail by 7. Russell kicks to Kobe. Hibbert inside. He's covered by Thompson. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot 2.
Oh, the officials are all over that one.
Clearly a foul. I mean, didn't give him any choice but to blow the whistle. I mean, you got to play without fouling.
And the Cavaliers will go with a different look here. Mozgov, he's checked in for Tristan Thompson. Fry comes in for Kevin Love. Shumpert is checked in for Smith. And it's Matthew Dellavedova in for Irving. Here's Dellavedova. He dishes it to Shumpert. Up top, Fry. 6 on the shot clock. LeBron, no luck.
His touch has disappeared on him this quarter. He just hasn't been able to get it going.
Cavs were one of the top teams in the East last year, and it was in large part to how strong they were at home.
What, did they shoot it well from beyond the arc at home, Kevin? I mean, top 3 in the league in terms of 3-point shooting. It does help to have LeBron, doesn't it?
It does. That is a factor. The Cavaliers leading by 3. 55 seconds left to play here in the first. Mozgov kicks to LeBron. LeBron with another miss.
He's been wayward and just off on about everything he's put up in this period.
Up top, Nance. Here's Wirtz. He's had some playing time, but no scoring yet from him. Left side, Nance. Lets it go from deep. No luck. Great D that time from James. Here's Shumpert. Rejected by Kobe. And they're able to recover. Passes it to Wirtz. Good look from Bryant. And the Lakers tack on 2 more.
That's how to orchestrate for your teammate. Terrific pass.
That will count. He got it up that time, but it wouldn't fall for him. At the end of 1, a... Off we go, a close game, now starting the second quarter. What stands out to you from the Cavaliers in this one?
It's just been a long-range battle for them, and one that they're winning right now.
Yes, yeah, sharp shooting from deep, a big part of why they're up.
The Lakers trail. And now let's check out the lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Here's the second quarter of play. Taking a look at the Lakers. Russell is out there with Jordan Clarkson. Then there's Larry Nance. Then it's Williams. and it's Bass in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. Shot clock at 3, and they take the lead. Williams has got the second quarter going with the first basket of the period for Los Angeles. Cleveland's gone 3-7 tonight from three-point territory. Lou Williams won the sixth man award last year, Clark, in the NBA. He's not a playmaker, although he kind of plays that position a little bit. This guy scores the ball very well coming off the bench.
He really does. I mean, he looks like a guard because of his size, but he's truly an explosive scorer. And that's the strength of his game, and that's who he is and what he does.
Now here's Thompson, quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game.
Nobody even close to him, and he can't believe he doesn't knock it down.
Nance. His three-pointer is off the mark.
You know, and when you look at Lou Williams, he's always had a shooting guard skill set and kind of a point guard's body. Now, he's not just a long-range bomber. He will attack the basket and earn his share of trips to the foul line. And that's where he's really deadly, 86% from the stripe last season.
The shot by Clarkson, no good. Cavaliers trailing. Smith dishes to Love. Back to Smith, jacks up a 3, that falls, great assist by Love.
And you know, back to Williams, sometimes it's better to own one thing, be a master at that, than try to fit a round peg into a square hole. I mean,
they can't guard us on the perimeter. Spread the floor, isolate up top. Spacing, fellas, spacing.
Jelly and butter on his toast.
So timeout called here, the first for Los Angeles.
And guys, the Lakers last season were just a completely different team after Kobe's injury. Not so much in results, but just in how they played on the floor. They actually fared better without Kobe than most thought they would.
Making a change here. Randle's checked in. Lakers have gotten only one of their first four shots in the second quarter to drop. And for the Lakers without Kobe last season, it was really a stark difference in styles of play and quality. No single person, Clark, stepped in to carry their offense. It took a group effort.
Well, you know, it was almost April, Kevin, before somebody surpassed Kobe in field goal attempts on the team. Be interesting to see how they build the offense this year.
And guys, this game won't be close for long if they keep giving up dunks like that.
No, it won't, G.A. You're right. A glaring error defensively and letting him get all the way to the basket that time.
But it's only 2 points. I mean, it was flashy, no doubt, but still, it only counts for two. Two is all.
Beyond the clock. The drive by Russell. Gets it to go from 18 feet away. Russell's got his first points in this one. Dishes it to Smith. The screen from Thompson. Russell against Irving. Back to Smith. Takes the 3. Good, and the assist goes to Irving. 8 points for J.R. Smith.
Boy, such outstanding patience and decision-making for them offensively.
Absolutely. Their ball movement has been outstanding, and they're piling up the assists.
Williams. Lead pass was put in just the right spot. Yes, Williams has got 4 points in the quarter.
He always knows where his teammate's going to be, and Kevin, that will let him put the ball where he wants it, right waiting for him.
Smith for 3. It's hauled in by Los Angeles.
Kevin, I didn't like that defensive effort at all, but they're lucky he missed it.
Yeah, you hope that's not indicative of the type of D they're going to play, because if they do, they're going to have struggles with him tonight.
Well, taking a look at Lou Williams last year, kind of a typical year for him. Him a lot of scoring on bad efficiency.
Yeah, and for Lou, he did make it over the 40% field goal mark, but just barely.
Just barely, you're right. And the Cavaliers will go with a different look here. Mozgov, he's checked in for Thompson. Fry comes in for Kevin Love. LeBron, he's checked in for J.R. Smith. And Shumpert in there for Matthew Dellavedova. Now here's James. Once again off the mark by Cleveland.
You know, with Williams, it's more about his ability to create his own shot than his efficiency. It's why he's best suited as a sixth man, in my opinion.
The drive by Bryant. And no good. Had a chance to take the lead. And here they go. Jumps up.
Whoa! Well, that fast break went according to plan.
Yeah, nice job there, Greg. Recognizing the opportunity was there to push it, and then excellent execution.
Special thanks to Kia for that sweet Kia Slam Cam replay. And so it's the Lakers with it, following the score by Cleveland. Shot from 16. Hits some rim on the way in, and the bucket's good. Bryant's got six.
And when he breaks out the crossover, you can be sure he's going to leave somebody in his wake.
Outside Irving. Pass to Fry. From deep. And that one's good. Fry's got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game.
This is really the story of the game here. They've been excellent from behind the arc.
Here's Randle. And he was fouled in the act of shooting. Chance here now for a three-point play.
And guys, they continue to put a lot of pressure on the interior defenders with the way they work down low.
It's becoming a theme in this game, Clark. They are piling up the points in the paint.
Larry Nance has checked in for Clarkson. The Cavaliers have gotten just over 50% of their shots to drop here in the second quarter. They're 5 for 9. Feeds to Shumpert. Outside Irving. Another three for Cleveland. Bryant with it. From deep three-point range, he got it up in time. And so it's a close game as we wrap up the first half of basketball. Cavaliers lead by 4. It's the NBA on 2K Sports from Quicken Loans Arena.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Well, two quarters down, two to go. Welcome back, Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, and Kenny the Jet Smith as we start breaking it down for you. Kyrie Irving was red hot to start the first. He had 13 points, 2 rebounds, and 1 assist. Kenny, your thoughts. How are the Cavaliers playing?
Well, they were lighting it up from 3, and that was the difference in the first half. They did a good job of running off screens, spotting up, and getting rid of the ball quickly. And their shot selection, solid.
Shaq, your take on the Lakers.
They're giving up way too many good looks. You want to keep your opponent under 50% shooting? They have not done that. What's the solution? Maybe more ball pressure, more physicality down low. Whatever it is, Ernie, they need to figure it out.
And that'll do it for now as the second half of our game is about to get underway. Kevin Harlan has the call.
Welcome back, everybody. The start of the second half getting underway. Both teams battling hard through the first half.
Well, Irving has simply been great. He's got 13 points, and from downtown, he's buried 3 three-pointers.
Well, when he squared himself up and gotten good looks, he's knocked them down.
J.R. Smith and LeBron at the 2 and 3. Tristan Thompson is out there with Kevin Love, and it's Irving at the point guard position. That's the group starting the second half for Tyronn Lue. All alone.
Oh, my goodness. He's just getting nasty on them now. Wow.
Yeah, now that they've built up a lead, this is when he really breaks out those incredibly slick moves.
Man, like a Ginsu knife, just slicing and dicing.
And the highlight reel replay brought to you by Kia. Good stuff on that Kia Slam Cam. Second shot opportunity. Great D that time from Hibbert.
That's terrific defense right there to prevent from converting in close.
Russell against Love. The drive by Russell. Good on the shot. Russell's got his second bucket.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Well, I agree with you. 4 of their last 5 baskets have been exactly of that variety.
And the shot is good. And for LeBron James, a remarkable step. Greg, he had increased his field goal percentage for seven consecutive seasons going into 2014.
Yeah, a steep decline last season, though, back below 50%. Was it just the challenge of new teams?
They can't guard us on the perimeter. Spread the floor and isolate up top. Spacing, fellas. Spacing.
Timeout called the Lakers.
And you know, with LeBron, he's played over 40,000 career minutes. He played more than Larry Bird did his entire career, more than NBA Ironman Andre Miller as well. And those miles take their toll.
Catching up on the changes for Cleveland. Mozgov, he's checked in for Thompson. Shumper comes in for Smith. And it's Matthew Dellavedova in for Irving. And we're just about a minute and a half into the third quarter of basketball. Randle no good.
And for LeBron, last season, the longest injury absence of his career. I think he's smart to protect his body, though. If he can keep healthy, he can play for a long time at a very high level.
Here is Russell following the basket by LeBron James. And the shot is good. And that's now 6 points for Roy Hibbert. The Cavaliers leading by six. The dish to Mozgov. Dellavedova kicks to James. And it's good, assisting on the play with Dellavedova. LeBron's got 9 points here in the second half. Lakers have gone 2 of 5, shooting here in the third quarter. A three from Bryant. Mozgov grabs the board.
It's been a real difficult game for him offensively, and it's cost him.
James, no good.
That's not the type of opportunity he fails to convert very often.
Russell against Shumpert. Russell passes to Randle. Mozgov with the block. Now here's Love. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Pass to James. Shoots. Off target there. That would have pushed the lead to double digits. Well, you go back last season, the Cavs had a very slow start to the year. Not surprising. They had a lot of new faces and people they were bringing together. Clark, it didn't look like the powerhouse they would end up being as a result.
Well, you know, they were kind of fumbling and bumbling around in the fifth and sixth spots in the East for the first half of the season. Made some changes, though, through trade, and that got them going, I think.
A shot by Clarkson, no good.
Trailing here in the game, you can look at his performance as a direct indicator of why they're losing.
And that one's good.
And really, it looks like he may just try to take this thing over on his own and really build that lead up.
And Cleveland making a change here. Prize checked in.
And those midseason trades for the Cavs really turned things around. Mozgov came in, J.R. Smith and Shumpert secured that two spot, gave this team an incredible edge defensively.
Yeah, and you know, they built the roster to how they played best midseason. I mean, it was a great job, I think, by the front office to get the players that fit best into the locker room and into the team style of play.
Now here's LeBron following the miss by Lewis Williams. And there's the basket. Whistle blows and a chance for a three-point play going to the line for one. Let's check in for LeBron. Cleveland shooting their fourth attempt at the free throw line right here. Free throw good. Amon Shumpert.
And for Kevin Love last season, he didn't want to be called a stretch four, but the numbers suggest he was exactly that. Nearly one out of every two shots he took was from three, a much higher ratio than at any other time in his career. Now, how about how he sets his man up there, runs him right into the screen, and then gets the basket?
There's 53 seconds left in the third. Here's Dellavedova. He's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Off target with his three. A as Greg was talking about Clark back to Love, it wasn't his choice to camp out from three last year. It was designed that way to create operating space for both LeBron and Kyrie.
Yeah, and you think about it, it's hard to ask a successful post player not to play to his strengths, but Love made the sacrifice, and I don't think he gets enough credit for that, Kevin.
Here's Dellavedova, following the basket by Kobe Bryant. Stolen. 2 second difference between shot clock and game clock. Here's Williams, and the layup is good. Williams has got it back down to single digits for Los Angeles.
That's really how they're going to get back into this game, trim the lead. I mean, play tough defense, force some turnovers, and then push it to the other end.
And Clark, those steals allow you to play in the open floor.
It's deflected. They get it back, and that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Bass. Smith for three. That's good. Smith's got 11. Here's Kobe. With one on the clock. And as we end the third quarter, a double-digit deficit will make it tough to come back. Cavaliers ahead. They lead by 12. And we're just moments away from the start of the fourth quarter. Stay with us. And we welcome you back as we get going here in the fourth quarter. The final quarter of play can change everything. The Cavaliers leading by 12. So for the Lakers right now, they've got Roy Hibbert. Larry Nance out there with Randall. Then there's Jordan Clarkson, and it's Russell in at the one. Lakers shooting pretty well at 46% from the floor. He feeds it to Clarkson. Hibbert with a screen on Smith. Clarkson dishes to Hibbert, and he comes off the screen and slams it through.
Threw it down with authority.
Oh, he can really fly. And you combine that, Clark, with some of the nice penetration, too, and you've got an easy 2 points.
And able to just play well above the rim. I mean, that makes this guy so dangerous when he's in the game.
Now Randall. Russell with a wide open look. Out to Nance. Lakers passing it around. Up top, Russell, covered by Irving. Tries yet again, and Hibbert the bucket on the assist by Russell. 10 points for Roy Hibbert.
Well, he knew how many inches he had over the guy. I mean, let's face it, good decision to just rise up and take the jump shot.
And he gets the bucket.
And we've seen him do that before. Batter a defense by just exploding to the basket.
Look at LeBron James. He's really been playing well.
He's been attacking the rim with reckless abandon. They're searching for answers. Some way they've got to figure out how to contain it.
And let's get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
Yes, during that break, Coach Byron Scott had some words for his team. He was not happy with their play to this point, telling them, "We're getting out hustled, plain and simple. There's still time, but we've got to dial up our effort. Kevin, we'll see if they have enough to get it done."
Thanks again, Doris.
Excellent work there in transition.
Yeah, I think it's always better to go early in transition, to attack when it's there, because oftentimes you can beat the defense down the floor.
Now, here's Clarkson from the high post, and the rejection by Smith. Picked by Randall. Down to 5 on the shot clock. And so he draws the foul on the shot, a trip to the line to shoot 2. And guys, let's get your take on the scoring breakdown for the Cavaliers.
Guys, the passing we've seen from them has been tremendous. Very unselfish.
Yeah, and it doesn't hurt to be on fire from beyond. They have been really good from the 3-point line.
On occasions last year, the Lakers were all right on offense. Other times, they were just stagnant. There was just no motion, nothing going on.
That's a great point. And their ball movement could use some work. A lot of ISOs last season, and it killed a lot of the flow the team had in the half court.
Great assist that time by Kyrie Irving.
Lakers trail by 13. Outside, Russell. LeBron with the block.
And that'll increase their rebound advantage. They've definitely been winning that battle on the board.
You know what? No rebounds, no rings, and they've controlled the boards, and that's what's given them control of this game. And one thing about Tristan Thompson, he is an absolute terror on the offensive glass. Was top five in that category last year, despite playing less than 27 minutes a game. Does a terrific job with anticipation of the carom and uses his gigantic wingspan to just go up and reel it in. Terrific motor and nose for the glass.
Greg, you were talking about Tristan Thompson. LeBron came out and said he's one of the best pick-and-roll defenders in the NBA. And, Clark, that's high praise from the King.
No doubt. I mean, Thompson is an emerging force. If he could just develop his shooting stroke a little more, then you're talking about a very, very valuable player.
Good point.
And, you know, one thing that comes to mind with Kobe is his incredible dedication to winning. I mean, you wonder if that has turned off potential free agents. Maybe he's a bit too competitive, but, you know, when you're in the business of competing, hard for me to imagine you can be too competitive.
Bryant hits them both. With Kobe and his competitiveness, it is something that he's coped with. Said it took him a while in the league, Clark, to realize not everyone loves basketball as much as he does.
Yeah, you know, even if you don't have the same kind of drive that has propelled Kobe all these years, I think you have to respect him for it. It shouldn't be a problem for potential free agents, in my opinion.
Cleveland leading by 14. The drive by James, and the foul goes on Roy Hibbert. That is his first foul of the game.
I mean, I like the call. I thought the defense was just there a little late.
Yeah, it looked like it. I mean, he kind of slid underneath as he got to the spot, too.
On defense, the Lakers. Outside Irving. Good, and the assist goes to LeBron. LeBron's got three assists in the game.
Boy, they've gone on this run, and ball movement has been a big key.
It really has, Clark. The defense unable to react as quickly as necessary in terms of dealing with their passing.
You know, so many games are decided by which team wins the rebound battle, and that's held true in this one so far.
And, Clark, their effort on the glass has given them the advantage, but it's also been the effort in general that's made a difference.
And here are the Cavaliers. They're on a 12-3 run. Love outside. Kicks to LeBron. It's stolen by Bryant. A look at the clock. A little under 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth. And he gets it to go. Kobe's got 4 points in the quarter.
And so just rolling to the finish line now in what has been a very confident-looking performance for the Cavaliers.
The sheer volume of three-pointers was the deciding factor tonight, it seemed.
Yeah, they sink one, Kevin, and then they do it again. It worked.
And you have to look back at this and see the huge game it was for James. It was the kind of game for him that all scorers dream of, where the basket seemed as wide as a barrel.
Here's LeBron. Following the basket by Kobe Bryant. LeBron with another miss. Outside Russell. Hibbert with a screen for Russell. The feed to Randle. Here's Hibbert. Cavaliers with the rebound. 58 seconds left in the fourth quarter. The drive by James. Smith with a wide open look. Good, and the assist goes to LeBron. And the Cavaliers lead by 18.
And you can sense the fact that they didn't want to let the fans down here. It's been a fun night to be in the building.
Greg, it really has been. I mean, such a lively, vibrant atmosphere, and no doubt that played a part in the big win.
And that'll be the Lakers as it goes out of bounds. Lakers retain possession. A platoon swap here for Cleveland. There's 39 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Outside Williams. There's the triple. It falls for the sixth time in seven tries this contest. That's 86%.
You know what, guys? He can really light it up from the perimeter at times.
Here's Dellavedova. And here's Fry for three. They get the rebound. Second shot opportunity. And the layup good by Mozgov.
Where's the box out? Some easy second chance opportunities there.
Those kinds of mistakes drive me crazy and will absolutely derail a team's chance to win.
And there's the pass to Nance. From 11 feet away, there's the bucket good. 5 seconds left in the game. Passes it to Shumpert. A three ball. Offline. So we see the Cavaliers taking the win here. Some good competition, but the hometown advantage and their ability to stay focused, I think, Clark, made the difference.
Well, you know, at this stage, you've got to defend your home floor, and they did that.
And now let's catch up with Doris Burke, who's standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Hi, Kevin. Well, LeBron, after a first half that looked like it could go either way, what was the difference maker down the stretch in this game?
Well, defensively, we stepped up. That's what it's all about with our team. We know if we get stops, we get a better opportunity to get a win and execute offensively.
LeBron, thank you. Kevin, back to you.
Thank you, Doris. Great interview once again. And that about wraps it up. This is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. We'll see you later.
The 2K Sports.
Hey, y'all. Ernie Johnson here, along with Kenny Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. Presentation of our Jordan player of the game, LeBron James. He found his rhythm in the second half, and there was no stopping him then. He was locked and loaded.
There's no doubt about it. This guy is a leader. He was in attack mode all night, calling for it and delivering in some big, big plays and baskets. His point total shows everything that I'm talking about. The defense was like, what am I going to do? And he was like, nothing, because I'm toying with you.
I don't know if there's a fan base that loves their star more than this crowd. Wow. I'm getting jealous. And he feeds off that support. Once they got behind him, he became unstoppable, man.
And that's it for our broadcast here tonight. But we're just getting started on a new season in the NBA. For Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith, Kevin Hart, K Sports Crew, I'm Ernie Johnson. We'll see you again soon.